This is Chronicle on WCVB Channel 5.
We know prices are up.
The 22% increase, which is huge.
Inventory's down.
There's so low turnover here.
How about helpful information for homebuyers?
A lot of buyers aren't aware of it.
Experts' secrets.
It's something that you can add to make your offer more attractive.
Overlooked advantages.
You can have a home in the 560s range and still have a tax rate under 4,500.
Undiscovered locations.
This type of a market is under the radar for people.
Real estate is next on Chronicle.
Good evening. If you're looking to buy a home in Greater Boston, you have our sympathies, but that's not all you will get from us tonight.
We're giving you information and advice to sharpen your house hunting skills. So put on your sneakers. We're moving at a fast speed.
Hopeful homeowners, listen up. If you want to succeed in the Greater Boston real estate market, you got to be ready to move fast, no matter your budget.
I think the biggest story of the year is that there's even less inventory than there was last year, though the demand is just as strong.
Make that a whopping 32% decrease in inventory across Massachusetts from January 2017 to January 2018, says Lisa Nickerson. She's CEO of Boston-based Nickerson Real Estate Partners, a sales and marketing company.
Over time, more people are staying here and more companies are coming here. So the good news is for people who own homes in Greater Boston, the value is going to continue to increase. Boston's one of the strongest markets in the country, and it will remain so.
What do you think is special about this one?
Nickerson sees a couple of new trends recently. For example, buyers are considering climate impacts before purchasing a home.
One, is there any sort of flooding in that area? Two, are the mature trees looking like? What type of damage could happen to their home or the roads? The commutes may be much longer, depending on what's happening.
Also, today's buyers are looking for extra convenience, even with starter homes.
We find that the millennials don't want more chores. They don't want to buy a home and start a family and suddenly have landscaping to do or a roof to worry about. And same thing with empty nesters.
A condo complex is as maintenance-free as it gets. Set on 60 acres in the South Shore town of Hanover is Sconset Landing. When construction is complete, this will be home to 130 condos and townhouses. This 1,400-square-foot, two-bedroom, two-bath condo is typical for a starter home here, says Director of Sales Sharon Vians.
It comes with a one-car attached garage. It starts in the $424,000 range up to the mid-$400 range, and the condo fee is in the $300 range. It's all they have to pay is their utilities and taxes.
The first two phases of construction are already sold out.
We launched phase three. We've already have a number of reservations in there, so we anticipate to sell out very quickly.
Nickerson, whose company is selling Sconset Landing, says that would-be buyers in any bracket need to be aggressive.
I think a lot of people have been waiting for the bubble, and since then interest rates have gone up, more people are looking to buy faster because they want, oh wait, maybe I don't want to miss buying now.
Maybe that's why single family starter homes are getting snapped up in towns like Linfield, a 35-minute drive north of Boston. Resident Marjorie Youngren is a realtor who writes for the Boston Globe.
People are coming here because the median sale price is half that of Winchester. But if you go back 4 years, Linfield's median sale price was actually 529. And over the past 4 years, it's gotten to 650, which is a 22% increase, which is huge.
Ellen Crawford of Century 21 is listing this 1,800-square-foot former summer cottage, 75 Prospect Avenue.
So this is about $575 to $599.
Built in 1925, this three-bedroom, two-bath colonial was renovated by a young couple in 2012.
They put in a beautiful breakfast area. They put in a brand-new kitchen, granite countertops, and then they did hand-scraped floors throughout the whole entire first level. A lot of buyers like move-in ready, and this home is.
But what if you're a city mouse wanting a city house?
Days on market has become so low, and this ritual of coming on Wednesday and going under contract the following Tuesday has become the norm.
Bruce Irving is talking about Cambridge, a hotbed of multiple bids. Irving and John Bigelow are agents with Compass Real Estate. They're listing this 682-square-foot condo at 321 Harvard Street for $589,000.
This building, my understanding was it was an Episcopal church built around the turn of the 20th century.
The sale is a rarity in this eye-catching 30-unit building in a quiet, leafy part of mid-Cambridge.
There's so low turnover here. I think in the last 10 years, it's publicly recorded sales, there were only four of them.
This south-facing unit has one bedroom and 1.5 baths. Coveted features include garage parking, in-unit laundry, and a balcony with a view.
If you took a look at the 680 square feet here, they're really well laid out, very simple, clean, low maintenance, low fuss.
Irving's top tip for home buyers: choose an agent who's an expert in the community you're targeting.
It is so competitive that you need somebody who lives and breathes this market to represent you. You need a good coach and shepherd.
And fun fact about Bruce Irving, he produced this old house on PBS for 17 years before he became a realtor. So he knows his houses for sure.
He knows his houses. And back to Marjorie Youngren, she warned sellers, do not put your house on the market too high. Buyers these days are more educated and know the market, and the houses that are on the market for too high, they sit while the other ones sell very quickly.
Very fast, as we heard. Well, learn the trick that certain agents don't even know about making the best offer.
When the sellers are looking at all the offers, they'll go to you first.